Good morning, good morning, and welcome to another Wednesday. My name is Steve Kribda, and this is the Wednesday Word. And man, I just want to welcome you. God has blessed us enough to come together again today to hang out, be with God for a few minutes today, to spend some time with Him and His Word, and the living Word, to spend time with God Himself, to be with Christ, to allow the Holy Spirit to speak into us, to bring us hope and embrace that love and that mercy gives to us. Today we're going to talk about some ups and downs of life. So dearest Father in Heaven, thank you this day for blessing us so richly, for being so great in our lives, for allowing us to come together again, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, for leading the way in the steps. You know, you've been so amazing to us in our lives to allow us to be alive and to constantly see hope, even in the midst of darkness sometimes. In Jesus' name, amen. So, a lot of times when we're walking through our days, it's easy to get tripped up. You know, I was out with Danielle last night, and we were on our way to our church board meeting, and we were walking across the sidewalk to walk into a little deli that we're going to go grab some dinner before the meeting. And man, we tripped. There was a bump in the sidewalk, and we both tripped over the same exact thing. And it was kind of funny. Danielle trips, and then I tripped after it as I'm looking down to see what she trips over. And we're not ready for it. It's because I wasn't ready for it. Even though that I saw the warning sign, though it being a split second before me, I just didn't see it. I didn't see the warning sign come. And that's how things happen to us, man. You know, we tend to go through life and, you know, it's interesting that, excuse me, I have the hiccups. It's interesting that we have these days where everything seems to be going our way. We have that perfect conversation with the person we want to talk to. You know, we have that, if you're in sports, maybe you scored a touchdown, shot the winning shot, or maybe you aced a big test. Maybe you get insight of what you're looking to create in your life. Maybe you jump on the scale and things are moving in the right direction. Or maybe you made it early somewhere and you didn't expect it. And all those days, I got to say, man, it's amazing. We sit back and a lot of times we say, oh, thank God for this day. Hopefully, we're being grateful for the days that are great or perception of great. Sometimes the sun, you start noticing the sun, you feel the sun differently, the heat of the sun, you see the trees differently, right? You see the world different. You might even have a bounce in your step. You got that swagger going on. And what's cool is that sometimes, what I'm going to say here about how I end the sentence, so stay with me about the cool part, is that it's God creating that brightness in your day. And we might not even notice Him. Don't notice the blessings He's bringing towards our lives. Because we're constantly looking in a different space. We're looking forward in a space of fear or doubt or insecurities or whatever. Well, the good part of that is, I told you there was a good part, is that He's like, that's okay, man. I get it. I'm still going to allow you back. I'm still going to receive you back. I'm still going to be cool with you. We look in Hebrews 12:3, it says, think about Jesus, full stop. He held on patiently while sinful men were doing evil things against Him. Look at Jesus' example so that you will not get tired and stop trying. You see, those days are plentiful. The giddy up in our step, it's our choice. You see, if we take a look at the word choice, we can choose to follow Christ and see Him working in every single thing, or we can choose differently. See, the moment that we allow ourselves to walk away from Christ, and, you know, it's interesting when I don't remember exactly the wording that I used in the post today. Let me take a quick peek here. Being around sin and darkness is that society. So then we walk into the people that we hang out with and see, you know, goodness gracious, if you scroll through social media, it is a plethora of complaining. It's amazing. And as you, and here's a neat thing. You ready for this? Are you ready for this? No, just kidding. I went back to the 90s for a second. So if you are ignoring those that are negative on your social media feeds and you give engagement to those that are positive in your feeds, it will shift. And what's interesting about that is it's how we create our input. You know, each morning, Monday through Friday, I've said this before, I spend, the boys and I, we spend about 10 minutes journaling to and from God, having a written conversation in our minds and dictating it on paper. And you know, there are some times, I don't know if you have children or not, but it's amazing how they lose track of time. You blink and they just went somewhere else. And you say, is everything done? And they say, yeah, everything's done. And then you go, what about this? And they go, oh, I forgot. And then you give them a list of things and about 50% of it is done. And you're like, oh my goodness. And then you get frustrated and then you're kind of grumpy. Well, that happens, right? They're kids all the way up to 18, 21, if you really want to go crazy. And the moment we sit down for two chairs, and sometimes when we're having this journal session with God, for the first few minutes, I can feel that the darkness trying to overcome me to keep my relationship away from Christ. And here was what's funny. If we go back to Hebrews 12:3, it says, he held on patiently while sinful men were doing evil things around him. In our society today, we have really moved in a funky direction. It's a very selfish society, in my opinion. I could be crazy. You can tell me I'm crazy. I'm good with that. I also believe that we are a very microwave society, meaning we need things right now, immediately. Let's do things right now. I need results right now. I need this right now. And that's just kind of one of those things. And when we don't get it, it gets frustrating for people. You know, I'm 47 years old. I remember dial-up internet where it would take like an hour to download one song from the internet. Now, if it's not in a half a second, you know, there's a complaining. Oh, I can't believe this stupid internet. It's terrible. And then we do all that kind of fun stuff. And then we have people that are just doom and gloomers. Watch the news is happening. We have all these negative things around us. And it's easy to fall into that and allow that to engulf us. Well, here's the thing. I'm just going to kind of step away from this in a second here. Whoever you're listening to or watching or whatever you're reading, it is meant to influence you. That's just the way it is. And we have a choice. We can allow the influences of negative or we can allow the influences of positive. You know, I'm incredibly blessed to be a coach and I get to speak with people all the time that are looking to increase the level of living. And when we falter, my very first thing that I think about is I wonder what the input has been. I know for me, if I'm not in the Word and if I'm not in my personal development, I open up a space for evil to jump in. And I mean evil, I mean the devil, man. He doesn't want you to be big. Because we have those days where it doesn't feel like anything's going right, right? Something happens, people laugh at you, you don't feel like you've fulfilled your mission for the day. Maybe you got your feelings hurt by somebody. And then your bounce and your step is gone, your swagger is gone, and then it feels like it's dark. And sometimes, and I use the word ironically, very loosely, it rains. It's raining outside. And you're like, man, it's raining outside. I can't believe it. It's all on me. It's raining because I'm having a bad day. If we're going to put meaning into things, how about we reframe it to create godly meaning in everything that's happening? It's raining because God's feeding his earth. Maybe he's telling us to slow down. Maybe he's reminding us of the blessing of the sun shining the day before. I really don't know. I do know that God's constantly working for your better interest. It's very apparent. But if you've, you know, I work out Jeez. I work out Monday through Friday, twice on Tuesday and Friday. And I got to tell you, there are some days I just don't want to do it. I'm just going to be honest with you. This morning was one of those days. I was so tired when I woke up this morning. I worked out twice yesterday. I'm so sore. I don't bounce back as well as I used to. But it's a training program in order for me to be equipped for what I'm looking to do for my life. It's a training program. I'm putting myself through discomfort, a physical and mental, to create something bigger than I ever have before in my life. And if you look at these days, how do we know that these dark days aren't part of God's training, his program that he has created for you? Excuse me. Imagine if you never had a dark day. Isn't it possible that God's training you to see his light? See, if everything's always hop, skippity, jumpy, right? Everything's great. Well, the great will become not so great after a while. And here's how I know. Those first 6 to maybe 8 to 12 months of marriage are amazingly fun because you're goofing off, you're still in that honeymoon phase, and then about year two or so, between 2 and 4, we become used to the person that we're with. And we become roommates instead of soulmates. Because we get used to the great, and the great then becomes good. See, just like a relationship with, just like a marriage, we have to be constantly looking for things to be grateful for in a marriage and stepping up to the plate and remembering exactly what is being provided in front of us by the other person. And giving 100% without any expectation of receiving, because when you do that, when we do that, we create a realm of vulnerability for the person we're with and allowing them to do the exact same thing. Because just like putting our faith in Christ, when we are vulnerable and we're actually, in order to truly receive the deepest and most affectionate love, we have to give ourselves completely. It's when we dip our toes in the faith pond instead of jumping into God's ocean. Whew. Talking to myself right now, just had to take a breather. How would we ever know that things are great if we don't know when things aren't? There's a Bible verse that I just started spending some time with. And I believe that this, I don't believe in bad times. I don't believe in negative times or, you know, Christ talks when the disciples were on the boat and they're going through that storm. The storm stopped when they focused on Christ. The only reason the storm was stormy and it was scary and crazy is because they took their eyes off of him. So if we think about that for a moment, if we're going through a storm or a perceived storm, I like perception. Is it only a perceived storm, or is it only a storm because we perceive it through the eyes of our non-faith? Or maybe our faith is kind of cool because we dipped our toes in the faith pond. Or are we ready to step out into his ocean, God's ocean of blessings? See, if we see everything that God is doing, I love it. I love this God's training program. I love that. I think that's cool. So when it feels like things are not going the way you want them to go, it's like, well, I wonder what God's training me for. Man, I can't even wait. That's what gets me in the gym. Being in the gym, by the way, as much as I like a little bit of a craziness, there's one area of my life where I can just let that aggression out, which is kind of fun. I like the adrenaline rush, is in the gym. And I like that feeling. However, it's not enough to get my butt in the gym. I got to tell you, just being honest here, 5 o'clock in the morning, I got to tell you what. I look at my clock all the time. I'm like, I could sleep literally an hour right now and still get my boys up and have them at school on purpose. Like an hour is a long time of sleep. However, what gets me out of bed is the result that I'm creating from that. Relying on God might not be an instantaneous relief. However, that long-term greatness of eternal life with Him, that's what we should be looking at all times. So I'm going to end it with this, and we'll close out in prayer. 2 Corinthians 9:8 says, "And God is able to bless you abundantly." Let me say it again, Rob. "And God is able to bless you abundantly so that in all things at all times, having all that you need, you will abound in every good work." What the what? Are you kidding me right now? He's going to bless you so much with everything you need at all times, with all things, so you can abound in every good work. So when you're looking to do Christ's work and spread His word of abundance and greatness, however your verbiage is, whether you're speaking scripture or you're speaking transformation into somebody, He is blessing you left and right. It's the moment that we quiet our minds, shut down, and stop doing everything else, stop serving, and look inward. That's when He's like, well, you're going to have to go through that by yourself, because I didn't put you here to serve you. I put you here to serve other people. And when you serve other people, I will bless you abundantly. Not sometimes, not with some things, but in all things at all times, having all that you need, you will abound in every good work. Dearest Father in heaven, thank you for this day, for blessing us so much. I'm fired up right now. Lord, thank you, Jesus, for allowing us to hear these words. Watch us as we go throughout this week. Let's keep our shield of armor around us, but let's peek through the holes of it, man, and see the greatness you have put in front of us. In Jesus' name, amen. I love you. Thank you for hanging out with me. God bless you, and I'll talk to y'all soon. Bye-bye.